love you. Many more people write in the African History Class want to say thank you so much to you. Rasko Jotona, Michael Latrekivuju, a.k.a. Gumesika. We appreciate you and we love you, right? Ras Osajifu Duwabil, Tindandogo, Gomadogo, Yinzore Bill.
Ya waleta matam sanga. Yabo!
Many more people right there, the African History Class. Stephen Kumamauli, I see you. Thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate you and we love you. Hey, see who I see. Many more people right there, the African History Class. Thank you so much. We appreciate you and we love all of you. See who I see here. TJ all the way inside Cass City, a.k.a. Kaso Asamojan, former captain of the Blakk Stars, is right there in the African History Class. And we say thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate you. He's wearing all black and we all know why. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate you, Mighty Don Duvasti, the Mad Kutoko engineer. I see you too, smiling at me, Blakk Lion, the general, all the way from Pram Pram. Oh my God. Ken Doku Okansi is also right here in the African History Class. Are you new in the class, sir? Oh, okay. All right. Thank you so much for joining us. You're going to enjoy the class. And all new students in the class, right after the class, all of you wait so that we'll initiate you properly into the African History Class. Emperor Kwame Anani is also right here in the class. Former President of the Republic of Ghana, John Aje Kumkufo, is also right here in the African History Class. All of you up on your feet. Stand innovation. Thank you, Mr. President, for joining us. We appreciate you, sir. All right, students, sit down. Thank you so much. We appreciate you. Many more people right here in the African History Class want to say thank you to all of you. We appreciate you. And I see many more people right here in the class. We want to say thank you so much to you and to you and to you and to you. See who I see, Buhari, the AC specialist, all the way inside Nima. We appreciate you and we love you. I see many more people. Chucky Popki is also in class. Thank you so much for joining us, Popki Popki. Yeah. Appreciated. Love, love every time. And this is Adam. Go get him. Thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate you and we love you. Many more people right here in the African History Class. I want to say I love you. Hey, see who I see in class. Thank you so much for my President of the Republic of Ghana, John Dramani Mahama. Thank you so much for joining us, sir. Sit down, sir. All right. All right, so we appreciate you. Last done. I see you too, right in the African History Class. Thank you. 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 I see many more people right here in the class. I see you and I appreciate you. Elon Bini, thank you. I appreciate you. Thank you for joining us. You can also be part of the African History Class. All you need to do is to follow me on Twitter. My Twitter handle is at Blakk Rasta. B-L-A-K-K-R-A-S-T-A. And it comes with a verified blue tick. Also follow us on 3FM 92.7. That's our Twitter handle. We appreciate you. We love you. Thank you so much. Now, if your name has not been mentioned, please feel no way. We will certainly mention your name before the end of the class. In the interim, all students up on your feet. All students up on your feet. Everybody, Sadia Hips, up on your feet. Up. Alasan Bakoso Ali Anamzuya. Okay, four of you are needed in front of the class. Alasan Bakoso Ali Anamzuya, come. Sadia Hips in front of the class. Hey, come. You two, come. Are you a new student, sir? Okay, or come, say, join us. Okay. And of course, TJ, join us right here in front of the class. And you know, this is what we're doing. Everybody up on your feet. Okay, let's go. And up, and down, and up, and down. To the left, to the right, to the left, to the right. Sit down. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. Well, my name is Blakk Rasta. I want to say thank you so much. Today, our class will last 15 minutes. Sit down, all of you. Sit down. Okay, sir. Sit down. All right, thank you so much. Behave yourselves, those at the back. Interesting. Today, I'm taking you all the way to America, and I'm going to tell you a story that's going to blow your mind. It's going to last maximum 15 minutes. I said maximum 15 minutes. Today, my brother, my sister, hey, we're still talking about slave revolts. And today I'm going to talk about one of the most successful slave revolts in the history of Blakk slave revolt in the world. Today, my brother, my sister, I'm going to be talking about a man whose photograph you already see in the African history class. Now, this is the photograph of Madison Washington. Madison Washington. He was a Blakk man who was sold into slavery, and he did a lot of things on the ship known as the Creole. Creole. Repeat after me, students. Creole. C-R-E-O-L-E. Creole. What does Creole mean? Students, anybody with an idea? Now, when you say Creole, it is broken French. Broken French. Now, it could also represent any broken language. You can call it Creole. But it is an indigenous language of the people of Sierra Leone, Liberia, and some other such areas. In fact, mostly in the so-called Francophone areas of the world. My brother, my sister, today we're talking about Madison Washington. Madison is spelled M-A-D-I-S-O-N. Washington is W-A-S-H-I-N-G-T-O-N. In fact, he was carried as a slave all the way from the shores of Africa at the age of 41, circa. In fact, he was born circa 1800. Circa 1800. And when he was 41 years old, something interesting happened. Today we're talking about Madison Washington. Now, on November 7, 1841, when our hero was exactly 41 years old, he decided to stage a slave revolt on a ship that he was carried on. And this ship was known as the Big Creole. The Big Creole. The Big Creole was a big vessel that carried and transported slaves all the way, my brother, my sister, from Africa. On this day, it carried as many as 160 slaves. It carried as many as 160 slaves aboard the Big Creole, and it was making its way all the way to the Americas. In fact, on the way, a lot of them died because of maltreatment. A lot of them died. Out of the 160, only 134 survived. That meant that 26 of them died. Some of them were raped. Some of them were summarily executed and thrown into the sea to be swallowed up by sharks and eaten up by all sorts of life, aquatic life. My brother, my sister, on the 7th day of November, our hero for today, Madison Washington, having seen too much and having had enough, started talking to the slaves, telling them it was time to revolt. It was time to fight against the ship owners and to free themselves from slavery. In fact, he was a very learned slave who was able to listen to the radio whilst on the ship. And he heard that slavery had been abolished in the English territories around the world, including Nassau, oh, and some other parts of the world. Now, when he heard this, he started planning his revolt. He spoke with the slaves and put them in vantage positions to be able to strike on the ship known as the Big Creole. Now, see what happened. Now, the ship was originally moving from Virginia all the way to New Orleans as part of the coastwise slave trade. And when we talk about the coastwise slave trade, what are we talking about? We're talking about moving slaves from one coast to the other. My brother, my sister, this was prior to 1861, when ships moved from one coast to the other, selling slaves. And they were so notorious for that. Yabo! Now, out of the surviving 134 slaves, Washington realized that it was not all of them he could speak with. And at the end of this story, you would get to understand him more. He chose only 18 of these slaves. And he sat them down night after night, telling them how important it was to revolt. 18 of them he chose. And he trained them well, put them in vantage positions. And the rest of them were not even aware of what was happening. He chose 18 slaves. Interesting. Now, on the D-Day, the 7th day of November in 1841, Washington led all these 18 of his fellow slaves into rebellion. What they did was to kill the captain of the ship, the slave trader by name John R. Hewell. John R. Hewell, and Hewell is spelled H-E-W-E-L-L. In fact, they killed him, and after killing him, they subdued the whole of the crew and took their guns and ammunition. And at gunpoint, because they did not know how to pilot the ship, they asked the pilot to drive the ship all the way to Nassau. And you all know why he decided to go to Nassau. Students, do you all know why? Now, Nassau is the capital city, and in fact, the largest city of Bahamas. And it was an English colony at the time. And what happened? He had heard on the news that the English colonies had abolished slavery. So to drive them all the way from Virginia, all the way to Nassau, an island, meant that the ship was going to be driving them into freedom. And that was the wisdom behind it. My brother, my sister, Madison Washington, ordered at gunpoint, and they moved all the way towards the British Empire of Nassau. Now, the United Kingdom had already abolished slavery, as you were told, in 1833 in the British Empire. Now, despite American protests, the British declared the slaves to be free persons under their law and refused American demands for their return. In fact, slaves who had arrived on the British Empire were made free whilst the Americans were still holding them as slaves. The British had long decided that slave trade would be abolished. And when the slave trade was abolished, the Americans were still holding on to slavery. So any slave who found his way into the British Empire was automatically free. And that was why Madison Washington decided that the ship should move from the American territory all the way to Nassau. Now, they killed the slave trader, John R. Hewell, and the ship moved gradually into Nassau. And when they arrived in Nassau, all of them were safe. They were arrested by the British authorities and sent into custody. Now, they went to court, and when they arrived in court, they won their case. They had been taken slave, and when they asked for their freedom, the slave trader refused, so they killed him. But they spared the lives of all the other people on the ship because they obeyed their instructions to sail all the way to Nassau. Now listen to the interesting twist. Remember that they were 160 in all, 26 were maltreated and they died, 134 were left. He chose 18 out of the 134, and they successfully took over the whole ship and took it all the way to Nassau. Now, the interesting thing was this. Now, when the 18 people were all freed by the courts, automatically, the other slaves on the ship were also free. But interestingly, look at what happened. 128 decided that, yes, they will stay in Nassau as free people, and the rest of them refused. Five of them refused. Five people refused to be free. Can you believe this? Five out of the original 134 who survived refused their freedom and asked that the ship sailed back to America into slavery. Oh gosh. I know by now, students, you are asking, why would the five of them refuse their own freedom? They were used to slavery. They had been beaten, and they were made to believe that they were slaves for life. And so, the ship known as the Big Creole sailed back to Nassau, where the five went back into slavery. Today, my brother, my sister, we remember the wonderful man known as Madison Washington. He lived his life in Nassau, became a very successful businessman. He owned farms, and he settled down and had a family. Oh my God, he became one of the most successful ancestors of ours. Oh my God. Who fought slavery right from the top to the bottom. Today we remember you, Papa. Now in his story, we also remember that the abolitionist Henry Highland Garnet praised Madison Washington in his 1843 address to the slaves of the United States. 2 years after the slave revolt, calling Madison Washington a bright star of freedom who took his station in the constellation of true heroism. Now, this call for open rebellion was considered too radical for abolitionist William Lloyd Garrison. Now, Fred Douglass, who we spoke about today, my brother, my sister, wrote a novella, The Heroic Slave, and he was talking about Madison Washington. Now, this story, although very short, is considered one of the first known pieces of African-American fictional literature. Oh my God. And today, oh my God, William Wells Brown also included a chapter of Madison Washington in his book, The Blakk Man, his antecedents, his genius, and his achievements. Oh my God. Lydia Maria Child included a chapter on Madison Washington in her book, The Freed Men's Book. Today we remember you. We do not know when he died, but we do know that he's not alive anymore, having been born circa 1841. Today we remember you, Papa. He was one of the most successful slave revolters, better still, slave rebels. And he was succeeded in freeing everybody on the slave ship known as the Big Creole, except five who chose to go back into slavery. Papa, Papa, uninyaminko. Papa, misi uninyaminko. Oh, Papa. Papa, uninyaminko. Papa, uninyaminko. Uninyaminko. Papa uninyaminko. Papa uninyaminko wati. Papa uninyaminko. Papa uninyaminko. Uninyaminko wati. Papa minubeko wati. Papa misi minubeko. Papa. In the bed of knowledge, I ask you now that you know what to do. Be an enio lay me near by fey and zunda kagane mezaka yine. Yeah, bango bokaya nufifia in yanukai na wabana en webeding. Lele and jima singa be kune, lele and jima singa beeri. It's been the African history class. And in the bed of knowledge, I ask you again. Now that you know what to do, how will the story of Madison Washington impact your own life in recent times, in contemporary times? How would the life of this great man, oh my God, who found his place in the constellation of heroes through heroism, oh Madison Washington, today we remember you. Wherever you are, have a sound sleep.
Tutu gwavi, tutu gwavi, papa mula homeo, mama mula homeo, au na ima vinye, panum panum po, meke po, femi vie a, gwenam. bueno. Aovinye mba fanvio. Ao na ima vinye banum banum po. Ao na ima vinye banum.